Hey everybody, it's Sam with Wrestling Overtime, and I am here with your quick and easy, down and dirty, nitty-gritty results from NXT on March 11th, 2020. They started off with the NXT North American title match. It was Keith Lee versus Cameron Grimes. And this was a pretty good match. It had a lot of false finishes, but Keith Lee hit his finisher to retain his title. However, the big news was that Damian Priest came out and blindsided Keith Lee and hit him with a pipe. However, Dominik Dijakovic ran Priest off. But then Keith Lee hit Dominik with a spirit bomb. So we went on to our second match, which was Mia Yim versus Dakota Kai. Mia Yim goes to the big ladder match at TakeOver Tampa after hitting Dakota Kai with her codebreaker for the win. Kusha, excuse me, with Raw Mendoza. Kusha got a submission with his armbar to win against Raw Mendoza. The next matchup was Keegan Knox versus Deonna Purrazzo. I'm sorry if I butchered that name, but Keegan Knox qualified and is going to the ladder match at TakeOver Tampa by nailing the Shiniest Wizard for the win. And then for the main event, we had the NXT Tag Team title match, and it was the Bruiserweights versus the Undisputed Era. Well, after a knee from Matt Riddle, Pete Dunne hit his finisher and won the match to retain the tag belts. But here's where I need to tell you guys. It wasn't a match or anything, but there were two YouTube moments. You either need to go to YouTube and look them up, or you need to go to the WWE Network and look up these two moments. The first moment was when Charlotte Flair showed up. Her and Rhea Ripley cut a promo and then started brawling. The moment that you want to look for is when Charlotte Flair puts the figure four on Rhea Ripley around the ring post. It was awesome. Not the figure eight, the figure four. And the second moment that you want to look up, either on YouTube or the WWE Network, is at the end of the show. Johnny Gargano and Tommaso Ciampa started fighting backstage. Then, as they were brawling, they started moving through the set of NXT. And they ended up going up to the crow's nest where Ciampa got Gargano with the air raid crash off the balcony and through the announcer's table. Yes, you heard me right. It went off the balcony through the announcer's table. It was unbelievable. You need to look that up. And I will see and talk to you guys soon. Don't forget, if you have any questions, comments, problems, or protests, you can hit us up on Wrestling Overtimes on our Facebook page or our Twitter page, or you can write us at wrestlingovertime@gmail.com. And thank you, and we will talk to you soon.